Hi everybody, welcome back. Thank you guys so much for joining us. My name is Sarah, I'm the creator of Edzucating, and today we are going to be talking all about amphibians. So amphibians are a really amazing group of animals that live pretty much all over the world. There's about 8,000 species of amphibians, which includes frogs, which actually within frogs, that includes toads. So frogs tend to be a little bit better jumpers and they've got that smooth skin, unlike a toad. Amphibians also include salamanders, which within salamanders we see newts. And newts are a little bit more aquatic. They look a lot like a salamander, except their fingers are all webbed, so it helps them swim, and they've got a long paddle-like tail. And the last type of amphibian you guys might not be familiar with, it's called a Caecilian, and it looks almost like a worm. It doesn't have any arms or legs, and they spend almost all of their time underground. So you might be wondering what a bouncy little frog and a legless Caecilian have in common, because they probably look a lot different from one another. But let's find out. We are going to talk about what makes an amphibian. If you picture a type of amphibian like a salamander, you might almost compare it to a lizard, who's a reptile. They both have that long tail and four legs, and while they might look a lot alike, they are very different. Amphibians and reptiles are very, very different. But they do have a couple things in common. And one of those things is that reptiles and amphibians are cold-blooded. And this means that they cannot control their own body temperature. So if they're too cold, they have to go lay out in the sun, they have to bask to get that body temperature up. And if they're too warm, they need to go find a hiding space so that they can control their body temperature by getting out of the heat and letting their body temperatures drop a little bit. So you guys can imagine how this might be a little bit more challenging for an animal that lives in the desert, where summer and winter look really, really different, compared to an amphibian that lives in the rainforest, where it's pretty much the same temperature the year round. So depending on where they live, they have to have different adaptations and different skills that help them control their body temperature. Another thing that reptiles and amphibians both have in common is that they are vertebrates. They all have bones. So you picture a salamander has bones in those little legs, and so does a frog, and a Caecilian, that legless amphibian, he's got a big backbone running down his whole body. So their bones are a little bit different than ours, because remember, we're vertebrates too. If you guys feel your spine or move your fingers around, they're nice and hard. We have bones too. So mammals, reptiles, amphibians, we all are vertebrates. But bones in an amphibian look a little bit different. Ours are really dense and hard. They provide us support. But for an amphibian, a lot of times their bones are hollow and they're really lightweight, which allows them to do a whole bunch of different things. So a frog, part of the reason that they're such good jumpers is because they've got these lightweight bones and strong muscles. They can shoot themselves really far distances using those powerful legs. But an animal like a salamander, again, they've got bones in their arms, and those bones help provide support so they can dig. Salamanders are awesome, awesome burrowers. And same thing with the Caecilian. While they might not have any hands to help them dig, they are able to use that strong backbone to help push their little noses into the dirt to help them move around. So reptiles and amphibians, remember, are very different from one another, but they do have a couple things in common. Reptiles and amphibians can be really, really different based on their skin or their scales. So when you picture a snake or a lizard, they're really scaly. They have scales covering their whole bodies, but amphibians are not like that at all. Amphibians don't have scales. Instead, they have skin, but their skin is really special because it's really sensitive, and at all times, their skin has to be a little bit wet. So they have to live in areas where it's either really moist and that helps keep their skin wet, but if it's too dry, they either have to spend most of their time underground where the moisture is trapped, Or some amphibians are able to create like a mucus, a slimy stuff that they push out through their skin, and then they'll use their legs and they'll rub that slimy stuff all over their bodies to help keep their skin wet. Because if that skin dries out, they actually can die. And their skin is something we call permeable, which means that things can go in and out of it. So they can actually absorb oxygen through their skin. So you and I, when we take a big breath, we feel our lungs fill up. And amphibians do have lungs. They can breathe air kind of like we do, but they don't have to. They actually can absorb all of the oxygen they need through their skin. So actually, if some amphibians are underwater, there's actually lots of oxygen in water and they can absorb it through their skin. And that way, they can almost breathe underwater. It's really kind of incredible. But because their skin absorbs things that are in the water and in their environment, it makes them really, really sensitive. So we call amphibians an environmental indicator, which pretty much means that if amphibians are there and they're healthy, it means we know that the environment is healthy. Because if there are any pollutants or any toxins or things that aren't supposed to be there, the amphibians will absorb that into their skin and it's not good for them. So we know when there's lots of frogs and salamanders around in an ecosystem that there are not any pollutants and that it's a really healthy place. Something else amazing that amphibians do is they go through something called a metamorphosis. And this is basically what happens when a baby amphibian turns into an adult amphibian. So let's take a frog, for example. A mama frog is gonna lay her eggs in a pond or another body of water in a nice protected area where they're hidden. And over time, as the eggs hatch, out come these tadpoles, which actually can breathe water like a fish. They have gills and they spend their entire tadpole phase in this pond breathing in water like a fish does. And then over time, these tadpoles, they start to grow arms and legs and they start to absorb that tail back into their body. So when they're in this weird phase where they kind of look like a frog and kind of look like a tadpole, we call them a froglet. And then as more time passes, they get stronger, that whole tail gets absorbed into the frog, and they turn out to be an adult frog with four legs. So this metamorphosis process is really incredible, and it looks different for all the different types of amphibians, but for the most part, when the amphibians are babies, they can breathe water, and then when they're adults, they breathe air, just like you and I. So we just covered a lot of information about amphibians. So let's just do a little bit of a recap. So remember, today we learned that amphibians are cold-blooded, just like a reptile. If they want to warm up, they have to go lay in the sun. And if they want to cool down, they got to find a nice shaded spot. Amphibians are also like reptiles and us in that they're vertebrates. They have bones throughout their bodies, just like you and I do. Amphibians are also, they have skin instead of scales. Remember that skin has to stay wet at all times and it's a little bit permeable. It lets oxygen and other nutrients in and out. And lastly, amphibians go through a metamorphosis. They change from when they're babies to when they're adults. So we learned a lot about amphibians today, it was a lot, but the biggest thing I want you guys to remember is how sensitive amphibians are, how their skins can suck in anything dangerous or not good that we've put into the environment. So it's really important to remember that the way we treat our environment is gonna end up affecting our amphibians. If we want healthy frogs and healthy salamanders, we have to treat our ecosystems really, really good. We need to recycle. We need to not dump chemicals or any waste into the environment. And this is gonna make our amphibian friends really, really happy. So we're so glad you guys could join us today. Thank you so much for spending some time learning about amphibians with us. We have lots of fun resources on our website for you guys to check out, and we will see you soon.